Hello everyone, and thank you all for coming, especially those of you who have come from far and wide. I'm from Luton, very proud to be from Luton. I work at Luton Sixth Form College. As the people from Luton know, half of our students are Muslims. Everyone gets on fine. I just like to tell a story about when I was a lad in Luton in the 1970s. The reason I'm an anti-fascist and the reason I stick up for the Muslims of my town is when I was a lad in 1974, I'm sorry, I am that old, but I was a lad, a schoolboy in 1974, I was waiting for my mum to come home from work. My next door neighbour was Irish. She looked Irish, red hair, freckles, loads of children, usual thing. Anyway, I didn't know. I was standing out playing in my front garden and she came home from work. I don't know if you remember Skefco's. Used to be a big factory here in Luton. Anyway, Irish woman beaten up. Why? That same day, the IRA had planted bombs in a pub in Guildford. It might have been two, I don't know. And she was at work at Skefco's, a normal worker, but Irish. And there was the Irish terrorism thing going on. And yet when those terrorists did what they did, she was the one who got beaten up. Why? Just because she was Irish. And the same shit is going on now, that just because some people are fighting against imperialism in the way that they wish to, all Muslims are getting tarred with the same brush. And it's not on. And I just think we in Luton, we've got to stick together. And if that fascist wants to come back, we want to have 10 times as many more people here as we got today. Well done for coming, but it looks like we're going to have to do this again. And the next time we do it, we want everyone here. We want Irish, Bengali, Pakistani, Kashmiri, Eastern Europeans. Everyone in Luton who wants to live in peace and harmony is welcome to St George's Square whenever we want to. And we shouldn't let those fascists keep it for themselves. Enjoy the rest of the afternoon, everyone, and keep up the fight.